The last video we were discussed about the DBMS. What is database? What is DBMS? What is data and informations and characteristic of DBMS and user means the main component who are there in the database management system. In the second video, in the fifth point, types of database. Types of DBMS. So in this type of DBMS, we are going to discuss hierarchical, network, relational, and object-oriented. So we will discuss one by one how this type of database is working. There are four types of database management system on the data model, which are the follows. One is we will call as a hierarchical database management system. The second one we will call as a relational database management system. Third is network database management system. The fourth one is object-oriented database management system. Now we will discuss one by one. The first one we will call as a hierarchical. See, when you are organizing, when you are doing, it is depends on your organizations. We are going to be select which type of the model you want to be required. It may be hierarchical, relational, or it may be object. So how you want to be object oriented means how you want to be take your model. The first one is a hierarchical database management system. In hierarchical database management system is a system in which the data elements have one to many relationship. The one to many means we will call as 1:N. This DBMS organize like a tree structure similar to folder structure in your computer system. So it is be the main root. Under that we have a different hierarchy levels. The hierarchy starts from the root node connecting the child node to the parent node. This DBMS is good for storing the data about the item describing its future attributes and so on. So it is very easy. So that in our system, if suppose we are using any folder, particularly for example, we are using a different subject. So when we study different study. For example, if you are the fifth semester, you're going to study as a computer graphics. So in computer graphic, one folder and PHP, one folder. So another subject. So we have a ADA. So we have different three or four subject. So what is going to happen for one main subject means we can call as a main folder, that is fifth semester BCA. Under that, one more folder, that is the first subject, computer graphic. The second folder we will call as a PHP. So next, so on. So what is going to happen under that? Means inside the computer graphic, maybe you can create as a unit 1, unit 2, unit 3. So that is a hierarchy level you can take. So according to hierarchy level, I given one example, you can see that hierarchical database model. First one we will call as a first one is a employee. If you take as an employee, inside that we'll go for intern and permanent and contractor. So we have three type of things, people. Under the permanent, if you're going for under the permanent, this contract we cannot go for the permanent manager or engineer. When you're going for the permanent, you can say as a manager and engineer. So this is the one example. So you can take your own example once if you understand what is the hierarchical database management system. So hierarchical management system is nothing but 1:N, means 1:many. Here the main concept is employee. You can keep it as your own folder. You can create as a your own system. Next, we'll go for the relational management system. What is a relational management system? See, when you're going for the hierarchical, it is not connected. Means the connected means the main folder under the one more folder, permanent and contractor. Okay, and inside the permanent, we have manager and engineer. It is not means it is inside to inside. But when you're coming for the relational management system, it will be interchange. Two tables, we are taking from the two table the data and we are making as a new table and we are including the information. We are including the more rows or column according to requirement. For example, so what is this? The relational database management is a system which is data is organized in the two-dimensional table, means two-dimensional tables using row and column. This database management system was introduced by E.F. Hoare in 1970. It is called relational database because data within each table is related to each other. So that is the one I said to you. We have a two tables in that, for example, student's ID, name, age, and subject ID, name, teacher. So this table is different. This table is different. Only the year is the student's ID, means totally is different. We are going to be connecting. How we are going to be taking? We are taking as a student's ID. First, you are taking as a which students, which subject is taken, Okay, what is the marks he got it? So if subject ID 1 means it is a Java, the teacher is Mr. J. If subject 2 C++, Miss C. C means subject is 3, C sharp. So Mr. C, Harsh. So this is the way we are going to be connecting and we are introducing the new tables. So that is the one we will call as a relational database management system. What is going to happen? The relational database management system software is available for large mainframe system as well as for workstation and the personal computer also. We can connect it according to this. So next one, we'll go for network database management system. What is the network database management? It is, we will call as a one-to-one. The system in which the data elements have one-to-one relationship means or many-to-many. We can go for one-to-one or we can go for many-to-many. It is possible in the network system. So we can call as a end-to-end. So what we can do in the relational, means networking database management system, we can call as one-to-one and also we can call as end-to-end. This DBMS also has a hierarchical structure only, but it is organized data in graph like a structure. That is, first one we'll say has a tree like a structure, that is hierarchical. When you're coming for the networking, we will call as a graph like a structure. You hello to have more than one parent for the single one single record. For example, the teacher is a college, means for example, a teacher in a college teaches in the two departments. For example, school, book and class, we taken as a two. Maths, the maths subject will go for 8th standard also, 9th standard also, 10th standard also. Okay, and one-to-one also you can go, many-to-many also. English subject can take as the 8th standard PE students also. Means the topic may be changed, but the name will be English. Subject will be named as the English. So English language, it will come for the, according to ours, for degree levels, if you say, the English will take for the first semester also, second semester also, third semester also, fourth semester also, fifth semester also. So it may depends. Science, if you take, same like that, 8th, 9th, 10th. So it is one-to-one also we can go, many-to-many also it is possible. This is the one we will call as a networking database management system. The last one we are discussing, object-oriented database management system. What is that? You can see in the diagram, we have object-oriented programming, polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulations. These are things, it is going to be relation, means integrity and concurrency and query processing. It is going to be happening in the object, means according to polymorphism, according to inheritance, encapsulation, we are going for the integrity, concurrency and query processing. It is very, very important when we are studying for types of database management system. So what's happening here? So we have there are various hyphens which are created using object-oriented program language like C++, Java, which can be stored in the relational database according to, because encapsulation means one folder, means if you know, say C++, Java, when you keep inheritance, for example, inheritance is what is going to happen. We have inheritance, parents to students. So A to B, B to C. So we are inheriting. So these concept is applicable for the database management also. So it will play multimedia record in the relational database. Multimedia, if you know that multimedia, you know that how it is being syncing the multimedia record in the relational database can be definable data object. Okay, so it is very important and it is the real time that object oriented database play very significant role. Thank you.